Hello and hi everyone. Today, I would like to present about manufacturing process of center punch. Before that, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Wan Abdul Rahman bin Muhammad Fauzi, and that is my other teammate name that we have Aliza Nadira, Sharon Kuma, Johan, and Zulhairi. I will tell the introduction first. Okay, what is a punch? A punch basically a something shaped like a metal rod. So, the shape at the bottom has tip at one end and the flat surface on the top side. Then, what is the center punch? The center punch is the one of the type of punch. It's mainly used to mark center point during operation like drilling. Its tip is usually from 60 degree to 90 degree. And the material is used of center punch is mild steel. Why we choose a mild steel? Because the tool or common tool have used this material because of the strength. Then lastly, the ball pen hammer is used to mark the hole from the center punch. Now, we going to the next part, which is the process of drawing. And the drawing software that I use is SolidWorks. So, we go to the first step. The step one is we have to make a sketch on the front plane. The sketch is something like in the picture below. So we put all the meter in every part in the sketch to avoid an error when doing a 3D part. The next step is use revolve pose or base feature. The function revolve is to make a shape something like cylindrical shape from the sketch. As we can see in the picture, from the sketch art, we click the revolve pose or base from the feature part and make a shape like a cylindrical. The step 3, make a sketch or use helix spiral tool to make a helical path. Based on the picture below, we can see the helical is sketched on the body of center punch. Step 4 is use the cut sweep tool to cut along the helical path. As we can see, we have made a helical path on the body of center punch. Step 5 is mirror the cut sweep using the mirror tool. It means we can make another helical path only using a mirror tool. The last step is make a pattern of the mirror body and cut sweep using the circular pattern tool. So we can make a pattern like a diamond for the grip part of the center punch. The last part is the detailed drawing. If it means after we done of 3D part, we can make convert the 3D to the detailed drawing. It means all the dimension is shown in every part of center punch. Thank you for listening.
Material cutting. A lathe is a machine tool which turns cylindrical material, attach a cutting tool to it and cuts the material. The lathe is one of the machine tools most well used by machining. A material is firmly fixed to the chuck of a lathe. The lathe is switched on and the chuck is rotated. And since the table which fits the bike can be moved in the vertical direction and the right and left direction by operating some handles, it touch bike stick into the material by the operation and make a mechanical part. In material cutting, have three important elements. First, rotating speed. Second, cutting depth. Third, sanding speed. First is it expressed with the number of rotation RPM of the chuck of a lathe. When the rotating speed is high, processing speed become quick, and a processing surface is finally finished. However, since a little operation mistake may lead to the serious accident, it is better to set low rotating speed at the first stage. Second, cutting depth. The cutting depth of the tool effect of the processing speed and the roughness of surface. When the cutting depth is big, the processing speed become quick, but the surface temperature become high and it has rough surface. Moreover, a life of bike also become short. If you don't know a suitable cutting depth, it is better to set to small value. And third, sanding speed feed. The sanding speed of the tool also affect to the processing speed and the roughness of surface. When the sanding speed is high, the processing speed become quick. When the sanding speed is low, the surface is finished beautiful. There are manual sanding which turn and operates a handle, and automatic sanding which advance a bike automatically. A beginner must use the manual sanding because serious accident may be caused, such as touching the rotating chuck around the bike in automatic sanding. In center branch, we have 6 processes. First is material cutting, second is turning, third is facing, fourth is taper turning, sixth is nailing, and lastly finishing. First, the turning process. Adjust the machine to run the job to a required cutting speed. Fix the cutting tool in the tool post and centering operation is performed so that the axis of the job coincides with the lathe axis. Give the feed and depth of cut to the cutting tool, and planned turning operation is performed until the diameter of the workpiece reduced. Check the dimension by using vernier calipers. Reverse the workpiece in the chuck, and facing operation is performed to reduce the length of workpiece to the required dimensions. And again, planned turning operation is performed until the diameter of the workpiece is reduced.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Zuhairi Abdulaziz. So the next process is a process 4, which is we use a facing process. Facing is the process of removing metal from the end of a workpiece to produce a flat surface. Most often the workpiece is cylindrical. When a lathe cutting tool removes metal, it applies considerable tangential force to the workpiece. To safely perform a facing operation, the end of the workpiece must be positioned close to the jaws of the chuck. Next is a process 5, taper turning. Taper turning as a part of machining operation is the gradual reduction in diameter from one part of a cylindrical workpiece to another part. We use taper turning because when we use the center punch, the tape has to be free from any interference due to any surrounding material. Perhaps the only punch not using taper turning process is the transfer punch.
Good evening everyone. So, my name is Sharan Kumar and my matrix number is B0919103455. And this is my part for the assignment to explain about the knurling and finishing process of the center punch. So knurling is a process of empowering a diamond shaped pattern on the surface of a workpiece using a special knurling tool. So, there are three types of knurling patterns here: straight knurling, diamond knurling, and no knurling. Before we actually apply the knurling pattern, we need to know our knurl first. So when someone requests a diamond knurl or wants to roll a diamond pattern on the part, they have to actually answer several questions to clarify the pattern. The Okay, first we need to know whether the male breast pyramid or female D-plus pyramid pattern is required on the part to be rolled. So here we can see that we need to know first whether the part need to be rolled with the diamond pattern. So for that criteria to happen, we need to know whether the male breast pyramid or female D-plus pyramid pattern is required or not. Next, if the print just says diamondal, we actually assume it means a male diamond on the pattern, on the part. So we need to know the type of folder that we will be using for it. This is the process of rolling a male pattern from the cross stride. So use a set of RH and LH diagonal number if a two die folder. The roll can be fed axially at 0.005 per 0.30 per revolution if necessary. Knurling process will be absorbed in the folder if it can completely straddle the part, which highly reduces the part deflection and wear on the main spindle and cross slide. If only a single wheel bump holder is available, a female diamond knurling tool must be used. This method is actually advisable as long as the knurling section is relatively narrow. Rolling a male pattern from the turret. If a brown and sharp or other brand two die holder with swivel knurl blocks is available, use a set of two straight knurls set at an angle of 30 degrees. Feed axially onto the workpiece at approximately 0.10 per 0.30 per revolution. Bevel is actually not required for these knurls. If the knurl blocks do not swivel or you need to knurl closer to your shoulder, use a set of RH and LH diagonal knurls. Next, we're going to see about the rolling a female pattern. A female pattern on the workpiece can only be produced using a male diamond tool. Actually, we're going to need a male diamond knurl tool, diamond tool to produce the female pattern. This is normally accomplished by using a single beam pump knurl tool from the cross slide. Although it is possible to use two knurls in a straddle die folder, it is normally done because of tracking problems. Under normal circumstances, a single male or female knurling die cannot be fed along the axis of a part. If it is a necessity, the holder must be tipped slightly and the knurl fed axially so that it advances very close to one axis pitch, the two spacing for each revolution. Next, we'll see the finishing of the center punch. Finishing requires four different types of process: heat treatment, hardening, quenching, and tempering. For heat treatment, we can use this process to improve the metallurgical properties, which is the physical, chemical, and mechanical properties of the tool, of the part actually, without actually changing its shape and as our requirement. It improves the strength and performance. So in hardening, we heat the object above its critical temperature. So every object has critical temperature. In the hardening process, we have to exceed that critical temperature. We heat the punch around about 800 degrees Celsius in the of a oven. This is to improve the hardness of the material. Next, the quenching. When object is heated to its critical temperature, it should be removed and immediately put it into a cool liquid water or oil. Quenching gives the more hardness part. It is the part of hardening. We put the punch into the water. And last is the tempering. In this process, we give the low heat object. After quenching, it's actually possible for the object molecule to be damaged a bit, so it can change the environment. This process increases the ductility and the toughness of the material. We normally use a gas torch for this process. So the tempering part, actually, we are actually giving an additional of a low heat to actually increase the ductile and toughness of the material. So we see when we exceed the critical temperature, we might have actually damaged the molecules because we're changing the environment from a neutral to extremely hot and then to a very cool process. So the molecules will actually rumble on each other and they will be damaged. So by doing this low heat object, we're actually settling the molecules to the neutral state again, actually to make it stronger this time. So that's all for my part. Thank you.
Selamat sejahtera. My name is Johan. Now I would like to present about the conclusion. The manufacturing processes are the step through which raw materials are transformed into a final product. The manufacturing processes begins with the product design and material specification from which the product is made. These materials are then modified through manufacturing processes to become the required part. There are various manufacturing processes available in our manufacturing industry nowadays. These processes are very crucial to produce different kinds of products. Center punch, which is actually chosen by all five of our group members, are required these processes such as material cutting, turning, facing, taper turning, knurling, and finishing, which are the key processes to produce this ideal model. That's all from me. Thank you.